हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। आई श्रद्धा गजर एंड आई हैव मेड एजुकेशनल वीडियोस फॉर यू द फील्ड ऑफ साइकियाट्रिक नर्सिंग। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द वीडियो, डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड प्लीज लाइक द वीडियो। थैंक यू।
वी विल लर्न अबाउट द मेंटल हेल्थ केयर टीम और मल्टी डिसिप्लिनरी टीम इन मेंटल हेल्थ। ओके, व्हाट इज मेंटल हेल्थ टीम और विच आर द elements of mental health team. First one, what is mental health or multidisciplinary team? See the introduction. Multidisciplinary approach refers to collaboration between members of the different disciplines who provide specific service to the patient. Means what? It is a multitasking or multidisciplinary subjects are collaborating with each other for some common topic and they provide some specific service to the patients. Okay, they are from the different disciplines like these, some psychiatrist, psychiatric nurse, clinical psychologist and many other workers. They are collaborating and cooperatively they are working towards the solution or resolution of problems of the patients. So this is the multidisciplinary approach, or we can say multidisciplinary team. In multidisciplinary team, it includes, or we can say it contains, a psychiatrist. He or she is a psychiatrist doctor, then a psychiatrist nurse. A nurse has been done specialization in psychiatry, then a clinical psychologist, then psychiatric social worker, an occupational therapist, or we can say an activity therapist. They are providing therapy to the patients, then pharmacist and dietitians, and a counselor. So these are the multidisciplinary personas. They are working towards the solution of the problems. Now we will see in detail. A psychiatrist. Who is psychiatrist? He is a medical doctor with the specialization in psychiatry. Okay, he is also accountable for the medical diagnosis and the treatment of the patients. Other important function or roles of the psychiatrist are admitting patient into acute care setting, okay, then prescribing and monitoring psychopharmacological agents. They are providing or prescribing the drug or medication to the patient, then administer the electroconvulsive therapy, or we can say ECT, then conducting individual as well as the family therapy to the patients, then participating in interdisciplinary team meetings. Owing to their legal power to prescribe and write orders, that is the deception orders or admission orders, then the psychiatrist often function as a leader of the team. He is a main person or he is a chairperson of the multidisciplinary team. Now, second one is a psychiatric nurse. Who is psychiatric nurse? She is registered nurse with a specialization in the psychiatry or in the care and treatment of the psychiatric patients. Like, she may have a diploma in psychiatric nursing, MSc in psychiatric nursing, MPhil or PhD in psychiatric nursing. She is accountable for the biopsychosocial nursing care of patients and in their milieu. What is milieu? This is the surrounding area of the patient in that care provided to the patients. Which are the other roles of the psychiatric nurse? Administering and monitoring the medication as per the doctor's order, assisting in numerous psychiatric and physical treatments with the doctors, then participate in interdisciplinary team meetings to teach or provide the health education to the patients as well as the family members, then take the responsibility for patient's record. We have to maintain records of the patients, act as a patient's advocate and interact with patient's significant others. Okay, we have to do the interaction with the family members, with the neighbors as well as the other significant personals. So these are the role of the psychiatric nurse. Now, one, that is the clinical psychologist. Who is clinical psychologist? A clinical psychologist should have a master degree in psychology or else PhD in clinical psychology with a specialized training in mental health setting. Or he or she is accountable for the psychological assessment or testing or the treatments like IQ testing, some therapies, okay? Like they are some psychological, doing psychological testing of the persons. He offers direct service such as individual, family and the marital therapies to the patients. Okay, they are dealing with the, psychologists are dealing with the cognition or thinking process of the person, while psychiatrist is doing diagnosis, treatment and prescribing medications. Psychiatric social worker. A psychiatric social worker should have a master degree in social work or PhD degree with a specialized training in mental health setting. He is accountable for the family case work and community placement of the patients. He also conducts group therapy sessions for the patients. Then they emphasize intervention with the patient in the social environment in which he will live. Then, an occupational therapist, or we can say activity therapist. An occupational therapist or an activity therapist is accountable for the recreational, occupational and activity programs. Okay, they are organizing some occupational activity or some recreational or diversional activity for the patient who are mentally ill, and they organize some programs for that. He assists in the patient to gain skill that help them cope more effectively to gain or regain employment or to use leisure time. Means what? They are always maintaining or developing or gaining pre-skill which was present in the patients, and they also help to cope effectively to regain the employment, and they can earn the money. Also, they are helping to provide the diversional therapy as well as the how to use the leisure time. Counselor. This counselor. Counselor provides basic supportive counseling service, and they assist in the psychoeducational as well as the recreational activity to the patients. Okay, they are solving the problems of the patients and helpful in the recreational activity as well as the psychosocial or psychoeducational activities. The mental health team, or the members of the mental health team, or we can say multidisciplinary team in mental health. So if you have any query, any doubts, you can comment me in the comment box. Before that, don't forget to subscribe my channel and please like and share my video. And thank you guys, thank you for watching my video, and thank you to listening me. Thank you.